Hi everyone, it's Bardic Whispers, and today I'm going to be making a PC, a character ID, based off an item. So what we're going to do is just look up the trinket and item thing, then see what kind of class, and then potentially what kind of species or race we want to use of that as well. So I'll be using my new Viking dice for this. So, let us actually get rid of these old fellas and put them somewhere else, and I'll have to fix that up later. So, new Viking dice, they're really, really cool. Let's put them over there. Okie dokie. Trinkets. Le trinket. There's also Gods of the Universe, which is the cleric one I want to do as well. Focus, bardic, focus. Ability checks, blah 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 blah. Trinkets, 159. We should know where they are by this stage, but I forget. I hope everyone's doing well. I've had a bit of a rough time at work recently. It's been really quite tough, so creativity, focus, and drive to do things like this have been difficult, but we will soldier on, won't we, with that good old bardic inspiration. So, for trinkets, roll a d100. We have fight 20. A glass jar containing a weird bit of flesh floating in pickling fluid. A little morbid, a little bit gross. So, what can we do with that? Now, flesh immediately speaks out to me as a wizard, necrotic, necromancy, and stuff like that. But maybe we can look at something else, as it being a religious or another sort of piece. Doesn't necessarily say what kind of flesh, so it can be a little bit weird. So it could be a ranger that is his major beast hunting is fae. The weird could be a bit of flesh like that, or it could be like a doppelganger or something like that. So you can have a hunter. Or if it's for research purposes, you could have more alchemist. Artificer alchemist or something like that. So let's have a think. And we'll see what we can do. Also, it could just be a morbid trait of a particular race. A jar of weird flesh in pickling oil. Okay. I think we might go to the exotic multiverse races. Potentially. Changeling, Sundrin, Jurika, Firebog, Fairy, Genesee, Githzer, Githyankee, Goblin, Kanku, Kobold, Lizardfolk. Shagai, Sea Elf, Tabaxi, Shifter, Tortle, Triton, Wiyuanti, I think maybe a Lizardfolk. The Hungry Jaws.
Yes.
Let us go with the race. Was it like? Why? They have a swimming speed and the same as their walking speed. You have a fanged paw. Slashing damage rather than bludgeoning. Hold breath, you can hold your breath up to 15 minutes at a time. Hungry jaws, you can throw yourself into a feeding frenzy. As a bonus action, you can make a special attack with your bite. If the attack hits, it deals normal damage and you gain temporary hit points equal to proficiency bonus. You can use this trait a number of times equal to your proficiency bonus, and you regain all expended uses when you finish a long rest. So I think with the lizardfolk having a little bit of flesh, it might have been something from a kill that they've treasured, or have a little bit of like maybe smelling salts, or sort of gives them confidence power, or they're hunting a particular flesh person, humanoid, that will facilitate that, or maybe it's from an exotic creature, like a changeling, and they're searching for them or something like that, so we'll use them as a flag. And I think... I think we'll call them Inkah. Inkah or lizard folk. Hmm. Excellent. Now, let's go to classes. What kind of classes? I think we might be looking at a fighter. I think we'll go down the more morbid hunting side of this. For this particular fighter, there's a battle master, champion, or is it ranger that we're looking for the beast? Looking for beastmaster. I'm also thinking about creating my own class in the future and going through the process of creating that, so I think that might be cool as well. Gauntlet fighter. Let us go in. Ranger. A favorite enemy, natural exploring. Favorite enemy, Ranger archetype, the hunter or the beastmaster. Favorite enemy, you choose a favorite enemy, apparitions, beasts, celestial, constructs, rangers, elementals, fae, fiend, giants. You can select two races of humanoid as a favorite and resumed advantage. So let's go with satyrs and dryads as the two species. The Beastmaster, so at a third level you gain the Beast Companion that accompanies you on your adventures and you gain to fight alongside you. Choose a beast that is no larger than a medium and the charge rating of 1/4, or Appendix D instances of a hawk, mastiff, panther as examples. Add to your proficiency bonus, so the beast they see and rolls the damage. Exceptional training, bestial fury, and share spells. Okay, so why don't we go and find what this quarter has a rating of 1/4? We pick up the monster book. We can go look at things. So, let's go look at miscellaneous creatures, 317. I think at the back of the book here somewhere we have. Have a challenge rating sequence somewhere. Current, jackal, lion, killer whale, giant toad, vulture, giant weasel, spider. There's a new giant coat. Giant penal, giant frog, giant elk, giant crocodile. I think we've got. Do I need to perhaps go? Let's go to find this. I know it is somewhere. Just let me look at my books. Monster lists. Here we go. Swampish. So let us go for swampy lands. There's the forests, hill, mountain, swamps. 1/4. We have a bollywog, constrictor snake, giant frog, giant lizard, giant poisonous snake, mud mephit, small swarms of roots. Swarm of ravens, winged kobold. I think maybe a kobold. Or a quarter, I think so. I think I've got some stats. Monsters. see here. So winged kobold, but not necessarily a sorcerer, but winged kobold for swamp areas, one quarter challenge. Excellent. So basically just a mini them. Okay. It's a lizard, swamp lizard, with a jar of flesh for it to track down, hunt, and always remember the taste of its favourite prey, the fae. Maybe a part of a dryad, which has elvish features, but is green and sort of like photosynthesis rather than humanoid or carbon based, and can tree stride and stuff, so and maybe they hunt more specifically. The dryads, because they want more things to be swamplands rather than forestlands, perhaps. Let us go to backstory. Now, I'm going to have a quick look at the top, because they are a hunter. So, I think that goes more plays into. Backgrounds 125. I think that plays more into not an acolyte, not a criminal, not a charlatan, not an entertainer, definitely not. Killed Allison, maybe a hunter. No, not really. Noble, maybe a hermit. I think Outlander will be more. So proficiencies in athletics and survival. So I need to also add those to my characters as well. Excellent. So they're going to be Outlander. Excellent feature, wandering, gathering to allow fresh water for yourself, other people each day provide it. Cool. Let's go with the D10 and the symbol we get for origin. Here with 6 bounty hunter. Bounty hunter because they're hunting, you know, a bit of a beastmaster hunter with effective prey. So they hunt fae, specifically dryads, for their tribe. D8 for personality traits. 8. I was. This is raised by wolves. Raised by alligators. Some more reptilian, raised by alligators. And that is fine to change. 4. The strongest are meant to rule. Meant to rule. is my duty to provide children to sustain my tribe. Not really. I bring a terrible wrath down on my evildoers who destroy my homeland. That's to bring harm to evildoers against tribe. The faith. I am enamored with pine and other intoxicants, and also include, like, you know, this weird piece of flesh and what they're trying to eat or what they're trying to find as well. So but it's all sort of combined, and the okay, cool. Let's have a think about this. So the lizard folk Inkah has a favoured prey of Fae. Distant war between the Fae and lizard folk has resulted in Inkah being raised by alligators after losing his actual tribe. He has a winged kobold companion that sort of enshrines or worships him almost like a dragon, like kobolds do. So Inkah has this sense of pride, strength, and elements of thinking that he might even be some kind of dragon. And there is the Kimono dragons. So we might actually make him sort of a little bit more Kimono dragon, sort of in style. So believes that the strong shall survive, and rule. He's raised by Kimono dragons and alligators, sort of reptilian, wild reptilian forces. Is very vengeful, very retaliatory, and very aggressive towards Fae creatures or Fae descendants. And is intoxicated and wants to either drink its problems away or hunt down to find more of this weird flesh that it carries on its person. So this would be sort of long, strong neck and kind of large body. Very muscular, very sort of strong, but like as a lizard with a strong neck. Sort of long, longish body, like a kimono dragon sort of standing up on a tree or something like that, so a long, strong tail. And sort of thick hind legs and sort of big strong arms and like a fanged maw, very slender, sort of smooth skinned, dark black skin. And another part of like sort of the hunting and the archetype aspect of the Kimono dragons actually poison or have a venomous bite or bacteria bite that slowly affects their prey, and they hunt them slowly as they go on, and you know, through attrition the creature finally falls and the Kimono then consumes them. So there's that element there as well. I'm not really good at drawing humanoid Kimono dragons, so we're just going to leave the drawing as like a rough light ring as per, and stuff. But I think that'd be really interesting. Very vengeful, very angry, very vicious sort of creature. Always mistrustful of Fae and other Rewatchwood Watts. So I think it's interesting to sort of work backwards. I know this is something that Travis Willingham does in Critical Role, is that he finds items or an object and then works backwards from that. If you watched Calamity, that's how he created his Krokra character, and why he chose the Filipino Eagle to model that off. Yeah, so a little bit of a sort of the backwards one, rather than creating trinkets to create the backstory. The trinket created the story from the front, and we identified what class, what race we could sort of potentially have this. And we've created sort of a backstory about this Fae war against the lizard folk in terms of, like, let's say, environmental, where swampland versus forest or Feywild, and sort of a clash, and to make sure that everything's like that. So he has this hatred for dryads that control and protect forests, and everything, is hunting them, and has been a bounty hunter for Fae, and has no transgressions in hunting and killing Fae creatures. Is evil in sort of alignment due to his willingness to have powerful rule, and his kobold, his winged kobold beast, familiar essentially, worships him like a dragon, so therefore we get the Kimono Dragon sort of side and visual aspects and stuff. So we'll sort of work through that. Really interesting character, I think. Very angry, maybe frustrating to play with, for other PCs being so vengeful and so angry, especially if some of the other characters are elves, anything like that. He might be quite sort of difficult if you're really, really leaning into the role playing of that, but also quite a bit of development if you sort of want to also follow that as well. Thank you, everyone. Enjoy your long rest.